Welcome back to the channel. We discuss everything low-code, no-code, AI, and automation. In today's video, we're going to be checking out a powerful automation tool that allows you to build AI agents, automations, scrapers, and so much more. If you've ever used Zapier or tools like N8N, this is going to be super familiar, but even more powerful as you can tap into all kinds of different models and pre-built nodes and integrations into powerful tools like Reddit, YouTube, Meta Ad Library, and so much more. We're gonna show you how to build an automation from beginning to end and highlight some of the powerful features that this app has, including switching different models at different steps in the workflow. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and dive in. Okay, so let's go ahead and jump in. We're going to be taking a look at Gumloop today. And Gumloop is such a powerful tool. You can build agents, you can build automations, you can access your agents and automations via an API endpoint. So you can build these into your apps, you can build backends, so much more. And we're going to show you a little bit around, and then we're going to go ahead and build this automation. So the first thing I want to show you here are some of the templates, just to give you some inspiration of different things that you can do with Gumloop. So they have a web scraping category. You can scrape the latest YC batch. You can get a property listing extractor cooked up, a URL metadata extractor, website tech profile. We go to browser-friendly extensions. We have one-click startup research, LinkedIn profile data extractor, SEO and marketing, blog post repurposer, keyword researcher, AI-generated press release. Super cool stuff. They've got things for newsletters. They've got things for sales and CRM. And you can build your own flows completely from scratch. That's what we're gonna do today. And we're gonna walk you through an automation from beginning to end. And as we build this, we're gonna show you some of the powerful features that Gumloop has to offer. This video is sponsored by Porkbun.com. Porkbun was named the number one domain registrar from 2023 to 2025 by USA Today and is refreshingly different from other ones like GoDaddy. They're proud to offer low prices on hundreds of different domain extensions, plus powerful hosting options and incredible support. They've got everything from .com domains to awesome ones like .pro, .dev, and .xyz. Every single domain at Porkbun comes with tons of freebies like SSL certificates, Whois privacy, DNS, and URL forwarding, because why pay for things that should be free, right? They've also got free trials for their link in bio tool that makes it easy to keep all your links to all your platforms in one place, plus web and email hosting trials. All of these incredible features and tools are backed by an incredible support, 365 days a year, and more 5-star reviews on Trustpilot from real customers than anyone else. Plus, we have a special offer for our viewers. Grab $1 off your next domain at Porkbun. Just use the code MakerThrive25 at checkout. Head to porkbun.com/MakerThrive and see why so many builders call Porkbun their go-to domain registrar. Okay, back to the video. So we're just gonna go ahead and hit create flow. You can create a flow from a template if you would like, of course, but we're gonna do this completely from scratch so you can see what this looks like. So the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna add an interface. And the interface is really for a third-party user to interact with your app, but it could also be used internally. So once we add this, we can just click in here and you can actually adjust everything on the screen. It's got this infinite canvas so you can build your flows out. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna add a title for our interface here. We just have to hit edit interface and we'll call this YouTube summarizer, because that's what we're gonna build today. So what we're gonna build today is a tool that summarizes YouTube videos. And I'll show you how it works, and then I'll show you how you could extend this app to do other things. Now we could upload a header image if we want. We can customize this, we can add an icon. We're not gonna do all that because we just wanna get right to building, but we can also add a description, summarize YouTube videos. A couple things here that we want to pass in. We want to have a text field here and we can call this the YouTube URL. We want to have a drop down here. And what we're going to do here is we're going to have three different options for summaries. We're going to have a detailed analysis, a short analysis, and sort of a medium analysis. So if we click this gear icon, we can choose our three options. I actually have another window open over here, so I'm gonna copy and paste these options from this window. Just a second here. Okay, so we have our high-level summary. That's our first option. Second option here is gonna be our medium-level summary. You can see that here. And then our third option is a detailed analysis. Okay, so we have our three options. We're gonna make this required field, and also the YouTube URL should be a required field. So we'll go ahead and turn that on. We'll call this summary depths. Okay, that should be enough for this. So this is sort of our interface. We can hit return to workflow here. And we have this nice little interface where a user can enter some information and they can choose their summary depth, high level, medium level, or detailed analysis. So next up, what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna wanna add another module or node to our workflow here. And if we search for YouTube, we can actually see they have a node that says get YouTube transcript. So we can go ahead and drag this in, okay? And then we also have one for AI. So we can just search AI and we can use this Ask AI module. Okay, so you can see how this is really cool here. This is just this like infinite canvas and you can start to drag and drop things around. And I'm gonna show you how to connect all this stuff here. So the first thing we wanna do is we wanna connect this interface to the YouTube transcript. And the way that we do that, once we click on that, we can drag this over. So now we have these sort of both connected. And what we're gonna do here is we are going to take a YouTube URL and we're just gonna put it in here. We're gonna choose a high level summary. And what's gonna happen here is we can actually pass in the variables from the first step into this second step. So as you can see, I now have the YouTube URL exposed to me here as an input for this node. So I can actually click this and just drag this here. So now the YouTube URL is being passed through to here. Now, in the Ask AI module, we're gonna take a prompt here and we're gonna paste this in. I have this open in another window. The provided content is a YouTube transcript. Summarize it and output just a summary in plain text and nothing else. And then what we wanna pass through here is the summary depth. And what we can actually do is we can click this and put this right there. So now it has the summary depth. And then we can actually connect this node to this one. So we can pass in the information from the YouTube transcript right into this. So we can say transcript. And then what we can do is we can click into this and we can see now that we can choose transcript here. So we can drag this into that. So let me move this around a little bit so it's a little bit more clear. So what we have going on here is we have an interface where a user puts in the YouTube URL, they choose what kind of summary they want. It goes to this node, which transcribes the YouTube video. And then it passes that transcription into this Ask AI, which will summarize it based on the length that we chose here in this first node. Okay, there's only one more step here, and this will be to output the data so that we can see it. And that output is accessible via an API endpoint, as I mentioned. So let's go ahead and search for output. And this is under flow basics. We have output, but we also have things like if-else statements, filters. You can chunk text, you can run code. You can do a ton of things. You can connect to Google Sheets. I just wanna show you some of the options here. You connect this HubSpot, you can have triggers. There's all kinds of different integrations. If we click into the integrations tab, like Airtable, Slack, Google Docs, Google Ads, Google Analytics, and the list goes on and on. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back to core nodes and then we're gonna go ahead and choose output as a flow basic. And we're gonna connect the output here to this. And then what we're gonna select here is the response. So we can select input. This will load up. And then we can pass the response in here and we're gonna get the output as a string. Now, I wanna show you something else. I'm gonna go ahead and save this. If we click up here in the upper right-hand corner, there's this tab called webhooks. You do have to be on a premium plan to use webhooks. But they actually give you the curl request. You can get it in Python, JavaScript, Java, C++, so that you can integrate this API endpoint into your app if you're building a backend flow for your application. Super, super cool. We actually did this and built an app and sold it. So really works, super powerful stuff. This is a really basic example. You can also have subflows within a flow so you can get really in depth with the options here. Just as an example, you could take this transcript and then you could generate like an ad text or maybe like a text for a short form video. Really, the possibilities are endless. I want to show you one last thing here in the Ask AI node. If we zoom in, you can see you can choose different models. So you can use GPT models, you can use Claude models from Anthropic, Google models, Perplexity models, DeepSeek models, and the list goes on and on and on. Let's just go ahead and choose OpenAI 04 mini here for this, and then we can go ahead and click save. Now, we have passed in a YouTube URL and we've chosen our summary depth. So let's go ahead and run this and see if it works. One other thing I will note is you can put in an error handler. So in case it can't find a video URL or something like that, it knows how to handle errors. We're not going to do that today, but just know that that is an option. So I'm going to go ahead and hit run and see what happens. Okay, it's getting the URL and we got an error. Let's go ahead and try this one more time. And if not, maybe we'll try a different YouTube URL. This YouTube URL may not be valid. Okay, let me go ahead and grab one real quick. Okay, let's try this again. We'll pass this in a new YouTube URL. We'll hit save and we'll hit run. And this should work. Okay, so that worked. I think my YouTube URL was just a bad YouTube URL. I didn't actually check that beforehand. And check this out, getting a nice summary from this YouTube URL. And this is a high level overview, so it's quite short. If we were to change this to be a more in-depth detailed analysis, we would get a longer output here. We can also, under the Ask AI, we can change the amount of, you could change the temperature, the max amount of tokens, the reasoning effort, all these types of things, so we can get more advanced results. If we were passing through multiple URLs, we could loop over the URLs and do all kinds of really cool stuff. Again, this is a super basic example, just to give you some ideas of things that you can build with Gumloop. This is working, and we spun this up in just a matter of minutes. And again, this is super, super basic. So if you wanted to build a more complex example, you could easily do so. Just wanted to give you a preview of this tool. I hope you like it. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Drop any questions below and subscribe to this channel so you don't miss any other videos like this one.